we are the group 8 and we are going to discuss about LLB in case study. In this case, we're gonna see the product benefits on employee, the SWOT of the company, the organizational objectives strategies, then the corporate values, and finally the recommendation for the company. I am Elise Dimitier, and I'm going to show that the products or service of the company have an impact on the employee and their satisfaction in the company. So the company is using two ways of bringing cohesion into the employee. The traditional benefits, the performance-based bonuses, cafeteria style, healthcare. They also have non-traditional benefits, which are store discount, fitness programs. The company also can give outdoor equipment to their employees so they can enjoy their own equipment, so dance, canoeing, etc. They also have a tradition, which is the Outdoor Adventure Days and Trips. It's a concept to connect the employee with LLB values, which are the love of the nature. And also for the company, the stakeholders are really important, so they are trying to show that by first bringing employee satisfaction to the company. So, I am Elise Dubertier, and I'm recording Arnold Bart. He's going to talk about strengths and weaknesses of the company. So, the external part of the SWOT. So, for this part of the SWOT, we can see that LLB company has a well-established outdoor brand. Since a century, it's a quite old brand, has a global presence because it's selling internationally in USA and Japan especially. It is a trusted brand in quality because they have a really good after-sale management service. Then the family-owned company enhances the profit margins are more and corporate as this hardness. They have a good product portfolio and a wide range because they can suggest different materials, colors for their shoes, but also for... So, unfortunately, the company also has weaknesses. It has to maintain a strong brand presence. Since it has established a niche door in outdoor, it will become difficult to diversify in new segments. And also, we can see that less international presence as compared to leading brands and their competitors. So, yeah, they have to be more present on international markets. So, I'm Alejandro, and I'm going to talk about external opportunities and threats that the company has and how the company responded to these factors from a sustainable perspective. So, let's start with the opportunities that are being found. First one is multi-channel marketing, cross-selling, so advertising and promotion. That is important too for companies and the company in the case said that they use the internet to stand out as a new marketing channel and online commercial services. Processes because there was an evolution and a trend on these processes around the market. There are so many cultural differences in the different countries. We're integrated in relation to the offer of the services, the budget to workers, for example, transportation costs, and subsidies are common labor benefits in Japan. There's an example in this case. There is a new trend in this time of social responsibility and finally a high performance in industries with mobiles and their productivity. That includes electronic purchases, mail on the home, electrical and electronic appliances stored, and more. It shows that there is a growing trend of the use of electronic devices for day-to-day. So now we're going to get all the threats. First of all, the global market of employees and customers more skills and aware of the calls in the United States. There is a huge problem there in the end of time. Highly competitive and possibly changing market, over-exploitation of workers with bad wages, the climate change is improved, hindering the performance of employees in production processes. According to what was identified, the company made a decision to implement new payment methods for its employees in the which encourage loyalty to the company and improve their performances. The marketing challenge were implemented in the case the company opted for online purchases and sales in order to simplify their marketing processes. They took advantage of cultural differences in the matter of providing incentives and reward facilities for their employees and the different groups of the where they operate. They're raising the moral and performance of this in the company. Finally, to improve their images for the future employees and for their clients, they carried out several social responsibility projects. Most of them because they started to create a trend around other companies on this issue, where they involved their employees to instill values and teach them new visions on how to help life after the company.
Hey, I am Andrea Ordóñez. I am going to talk about examples of traditional and non-traditional rewards and how they are used to meet organizational objectives. Examples about traditional rewards is offered at LLB include performance-based basic bonus and cafeteria-style healthcare. And non-traditional include the store discounts, on-site fitness program, and the use of company-owned outdoor gear such as tents and canoes. The company continues the tradition of outdoor adventure days and trips as a way to connect employees with the company values. The developing job description and conducting salary surveys allow the company to develop a comprehensive compensation and benefits framework to manage periods of rapid growth and diversification. As a result of the strategic review process, total rewards at the company became a core business practice critical to the accomplishment of organization goals. Thank you.
I will talk about how the company aligns its benefit with its corporate values. The LLB themselves believe in profit sharing with employees long before it became a certain compensation practice. But in days when pay was 18 cents an hour paid in more envelope of cash, millions of price employees with bonus calculated as percentage profits and the employees were paid on the company performance. This practice reflects the LLB philosophy that the employees' passion for the company and its products will translate to the customers. As far as being less concerned, the company had an obligation to the stakeholders and it began with employee satisfaction.
Well, I'm Elise, and I'm going to present the recommendation regarding the expansion of the benefits program offered at the company that will further align human resources with the accomplishment of organizational goals and value. As we could see in the case, the stakeholders are really important for the company and LLB CEO. So, they really want their employees satisfaction, and insuring them a stable salary would be a good option. Indeed, their employees are paid according to what they are selling, so if they are not selling anything, they can't be really well paid. So it's not a stable source of revenue. So we thought about ensuring them a salary every month and improve their satisfaction and provide a good employee situation.